Thank you. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. At this time, I'll just ask you to stand for a moment of silence. Thank you. Thank you very much. You may have your seats. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Today, we are gathered here to remember Glyn Barry Williams. He was a unique and special person who meant many things to many persons. Okay? At this time, we're going to do the commemoration by the family. We're going to ask you guys to just pay your last respects, reflect on Glyn, who he was to you, right? Could be your brother, could be your uncle, but at this time, we're gonna pay our final reflect on Glyn and how he was a loving person to each and every person, right? Especially to Brenda, Cheryl, and all his other colleagues. At this time, we're gonna have the eulogy read by Cheryl Collymore, Director of CNG International. Cheryl.
Good evening, everybody. It is 4 o'clock in Barbados. This funeral was meant to start at 4 o'clock, and for those of you who really knew Glyn, time was important. So it's 4 o'clock and we shall begin. Glyn Barry Williams was born on the Wirral in Merseyside in the UK to Ada and Hugh Williams. He was one of three siblings, his brothers being Alan, who is deceased, and Robert, who lives in Wales. The Williams family tree in the UK includes a niece, Bethan, nephews, Gareth, Nick, and Simon, and several younger great and great-great nieces and nephews. The name Glyn Barry Williams is a hardcore Welsh name, and Glyn considered himself a Welshman. He would look askance at people and correct them if they ever called him English. After becoming a Barbadian citizen, Glyn was exceptionally proud to call himself a Bajan. His roots were firmly working class, and he wore that fact as a badge of honour his whole life. It shaped the way he saw the world and made him a supporter of social justice and enabled him to have empathy with those persons who society tends to look down upon. At school, the young Glyn was not really interested in studying. Instead, he played every sport he could: football, rugby, cricket, and even basketball. However, it was on the athletic track in middle and long distance running that he came into his own. He was the under 15 schoolboy champion for Wales at 5,000 metres, and he never lost his passion for sport. As we are all aware, school teachers can have a profound impact on a person's life, and in Glyn's case, one of his teachers impacted him tremendously. Having become increasingly frustrated with the lack of schoolwork from Glyn, the teacher proclaimed to him, "Williams, you will never achieve anything." Well, with a determination that was entirely in character, Glyn set out to prove him wrong. On leaving school, Glyn became an apprentice engineer with Unilever. He then went on to gain a higher national diploma in mechanical engineering, followed by a Bachelor of Technology in Engineering, and then a Master's in Industrial Management. He later joined the University of Birmingham as a research associate and obtained his PhD in engineering production before being appointed to the position of lecturer in manufacturing engineering within the university. I think it's safe to say that Glyn succeeded in proving his old teacher wrong. It is entirely of Glyn's character that most people who knew him were unaware of his academic past or his PhD and his right to be called Dr. Glyn Williams. I would sometimes call him Doc, but most folks assumed it was just a nickname. Glyn was comfortable and secure in his own intellect and never felt the need to wear his qualifications on his sleeve. It was at Birmingham University in 1991 that I first met Glyn. We got on right away as we had a number of things in common. We were both council estate kids. We had both been engineering apprentices. We were both enthusiastic about manufacturing, and we both hated Margaret Thatcher with a passion. Sport remained an integral part of Glyn's life. He took part in it, he watched it, he coached it, he encouraged others to take part in it. And throughout the years, Glyn would take some form of exercise almost every single day. Glyn continued long-distance running well after he left school. He competed in 12 marathons, with his best time being a very competitive 2 hours and 13 minutes. Whilst living in Birmingham, Glyn joined Birchfield Harriers Athletic Club and competed for them. He eventually became a team coach to the middle distance running team and coached athletes who went on to make it into Team GB Athletic Squad. One of his favourite stories was that fellow Birchfield Club member, Denise Lewis, who went on to win Olympic gold for the heptathlon at the Sydney Olympics, once had Glyn in a headlock. We all took care never to ask why she had him in a headlock. For Christmas 2009, I gifted Glyn 4 golf lessons with golf pro Michael Marshall. Glyn had never previously spoken of wanting to play golf, but I thought he might enjoy the experience. And my goodness, did he ever. He never looked back. He had found a sport that once again challenged him. And over the years, he persevered and steadily improved his game. He was a member of the Barbados Golf Club at Durance, as well as at Rockley Golf Club. He made long-lasting friends at both clubs and was popular across the membership. In the year 2000, Glyn came to Barbados, and we co-founded the manufacturing consultancy C&G International Inc. Throughout its 22 years of existence, the company undertook large and small projects across the English-speaking Caribbean, assisting companies to achieve international standards and increase their exports. C&G completed projects for a variety of agencies, including the BIDC, Export TT, the OECS, the World Bank, and the Caribbean Development Bank. However, the project which Glyn always felt proudest of working with was with the Queen Elizabeth Hospital Food Service Department to assist to implement HACCP. He believed that particular project was of huge significance because every Bajan who would ever stay at the hospital would benefit from the project. And when the QEH passed their certification audit in 2015, they became the only public hospital in the Caribbean to achieve a HACCP certification. Over the years through C&G International, Glyn has trained thousands of delegates. His training style was always educational and fun. He would tell stories from his experiences, which would have delegates laughing out loud. One of his favorite was about why the taste of Guinness had once suddenly changed. The story involved chewed tobacco and some very dubious behavior from the chief brewer. I shall leave it at that. Speaking of alcoholic beverages, and you'll hear a lot about that with Glyn, it would be remiss if I did not include how Glyn was the co-founder of the Caribbean Rum and Beer Festival. Over 6 years, the event was held in Barbados, Grenada, and St. Martin. The 2 days of each festival were hard work, with a touch of mayhem and a whole lot of crazy bacchanal thrown in. But it was family and friends that made the festival a success, and they help to create treasured memories. For the last 18 years, Glyn has been together with Brenda. They made a wonderful couple. They spent time truly enjoying each other's company and making each other happy. When Glyn and Brenda traveled to the UK and stayed with my brother Chris, he nicknamed them Glenda, as they appeared to be joined at the hip. I remember how Glyn and Brenda traveled together and visited Glyn's family in Wales and in Yorkshire, and their fun trip to Ireland, where they visited the Guinness Museum and the Jameson Whiskey Distillery. I know how hard this time is for Brenda, and how much she will miss Glyn, the love of her life. I feel confident she will receive the love and support she needs at this difficult time from her friends and family. I need to add something to the end of this eulogy. Glyn passed away suddenly whilst my sister Wendy and her partner Malcolm are here on vacation from the UK and are staying with me. I have absolutely no idea how I would have got through the last couple of weeks without them being here with me. They were looking out for me and giving me support in precisely the manner I needed it. Thank you so much, guys. Perhaps this was yet another example of Glyn looking out for me for one final time. Personally, I shall never, ever forget Glyn Williams. He was loyal, sincere, funny, intelligent, and he had the loudest laugh in the room. Put quite simply, he was one of the good guys. Rest in peace, Glyn. You have earned it.
Thank you, Cheryl, for that wonderful eulogy. At this time, we're going to have a song, Endless Love, performed by Margaret Bovell-Lewis.
Good afternoon, friends. My condolences to friends and family and all acquaintances. This song I offer on behalf of Brenda. My love, there's only you in my life, the only thing that's right. My first love, you're every breath that I take, you're every step I make. And I want to share all my love with you. No one else will do. And your eyes, they tell me how much you care. You will always be my endless love. Two hearts that beat as one. Our lives have just begun. Forever. I'll hold you close in my arms. I can't resist your charms and love. I'll be that fool for you, I am sure. You know I don't mind, 'cause you, you mean the world to me. I know I found in you my endless love. Bum, 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 bum. Oh, and love, I'll be that fool for you, I am sure. You know I don't mind, and yes, you mean the world to me, 'cause no one can deny this love inside, and I'll give it all to you, my love, my endless love.
Thank you. Thank you. Endless love. Yes, at this time, we're going to have a poem, "Death is Nothing at All," by Henry Scott-Holland. It's going to be read by Assistant Commissioner of Police, Sylvester Lewis.
Good evening, all. Rhonda, Cheryl, all the other members of the Doc family, I bring condolences on behalf of the Commissioner of Police, Mr. Richard Boyce, and the 12 or 13 or 1400 other police officers in the Royal and the Barbados Police Service. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to read a poem to you. I was told that it was written by Henry Scott-Holland, but somehow when I read it, I saw Glenn's hand in it. I know after this session, somebody will come to me and say, yes, he wrote it. Death is nothing at all. It does not count. I've only slipped away into the next room. Nothing has happened. Everything remains the same, exactly as it was. I am I and you are you. And the whole life that we live so founded together is untouched, unchanged. Whatever we were to each other, that we are still. Call me by my old familiar name, Doc, Glenn. Speak of me in the easy way which you always use. Put no difference into your tone. I'm sorry, Glenn. We're no forced air of solemnity of sorrow. Laugh as we always laugh at the little jokes that we always enjoyed. For those of you who know the Doc well, that was his familiar stance when you were making a point. Because, you see, here in Barbados, I spoke Bajan and the Doc spoke Bromley. And for those of you who do not understand what I'm saying, you can imagine a man from St. Philip speaking to a man from St. Lucie. Play, laugh, think of me and smile for me. Let by name be ever the household word that it was, that it always was. Let it be spoken without an effort, without the ghost of a shadow upon it. Life means all that it ever meant. It's the same as it ever was. There is absolutely, absolute unbroken continuity. But what is this death but only a moment in time? And why should I be out of mind because I'm out of sight? I'm waiting for you for an interval. Somewhere very near, just around the corner, golf. All is well. Nothing is hurt, nothing is lost. One brief moment, and all may be as it was before. How we shall laugh at the trouble of parting if we meet again. And we will meet again. And I will have my golf sticks and balls, my friend. Rest in peace.
Thank you, Louis. At this time, I'd like to invite Romero Millington to do a tribute.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It's no surprise to see all of you here today. This speaks volumes to the character of the man Glyn was. We are here today because we all knew Glyn in some type of way, whether it's through family, friendship, business, or just socially. The real reason why we are here is to celebrate Glyn's life. Glyn's unexpected passing has taught me a rough lesson. Anyone that is close to me knows that anything I have to say about you, you will hear from me first. Unfortunately, not in this case. So Glyn, everyone will hear it with you today. You were a great man and a true friend. You're kind, genuine, and a true gentleman. Glyn, you were always up front and a straight talker. And as Mummy would always say, you never mix words. He was extremely fun-loving and loved to have a great time, drinks included. Glyn was also a very intellectual person, and this was a testament by his business acumen and his educational background. I learned a lot from Glyn, especially from seeing how he treated Mummy. I learned how to treat the lady in my life and show love always. Right, Natasha? I remember Mummy was visiting her friend Chantel. I had to catch the bus home. You remember that, Mummy? The rain was pouring that day, and Glyn's car wasn't working. Mummy had to walk from Garfield Sober's roundabout down to Rendezvous. Out of love and concern for Mummy, even though anyone that's close to Glyn knows he had a few challenges, you know, walking and stuff, Glyn walked up Rendezvous Hill in the pouring rain to meet Mummy, just to make sure that Mummy would get home safe. Every time we were together socially, we would always have lively discussions. The topics were always varied, from current affairs to local and international news, sports, you name it. Glyn always had an interesting point of view, usually backed by facts, except when we were discussing politics. Well, Belgian politics, let me say that. Cheryl, Louis, Rhonda, don't say anything. Don't say nothing at all. In fact, I would say Glyn always had like interesting and intellectual conversations, you know? And he was always willing to impart knowledge to anyone around him. Whenever we talk, he would always ask Ro, how was business going? And you know, we would discuss it over a beer, maybe two, three, sometimes four. Three. Let me say four. You know, who counting? You know. To be honest, I really admire Glyn. You know, he always give me advice, pointers on, you know, on business and life in general. And he would always share, like, you know, his personal experiences with me and stuff, you know. Yeah. And one thing about Glyn, he always liked to have a good laugh. I remember, oh, I don't think I ever tell you about this, though. Right. So apparently, when Glyn and Mommy first got together, right? Well, I shouldn't say this, but it's nothing bad. Mommy, like, anybody know Mommy well. Mommy liked to wash. So Glyn called me one day. I said, Ro, what you didn't tell me? I said, Glyn, tell you. He said, all right, let me explain. I was getting ready one morning to go to work. Mommy don't say nothing. And Glyn, you know, you've been in the wardrobe, you put on a shirt, you say, well, you know, everybody's do this. I ain't getting rid of the shirt, I ain't getting rid of the shirt. So Glyn put the shirt on, the, you know, rest it on the bed, put on another shirt and gone. When Glyn come home the evening, Glyn, I start laugh. When Glyn start talking, I know where this going. When Glyn get home, when Glyn get home, you see the shirt on the leg. But before he can say he saw the shirt on the line, I hear Mommy in the background saying, the shirt is on the line. Yeah. Yeah. No, 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 no. That was just one story. But the thing about Glyn, though, Glyn lived a full life. You know, he also enjoyed having a nice cold beer. You know? Oh, there's, I can tell this one now. Remember? So, during the COVID period, as you know, there was a ban on the sale of alcohol and stuff like that, right? Everybody experiences, and you know, Glyn too. We all experienced it. You couldn't buy any alcohol or anything. So anyhow, Mommy called me one day and said, "Ro, Glyn was a man always had his stock with beers and stuff." And you know, Mommy called and said, "Glyn, Romero, Glyn only got 12 beers in the fridge." I said, "Man, don't worry, man. Glyn can be good, man. Glyn can be good." Then she called me a few days later. "Ro, Glyn down to 6. You're getting a bit." I said, "Say no more. Say no more, man. Say no more. I got it covered." So that night, wait, Louis still here? Oh. That night, I called Mommy. I said, "Mommy, I come in there now. Open the door." So she knew what he meant. So when they get there now, I go on in the van, take out the stuff, go on upstairs. And Mommy, when they think I see Mommy got the door open, so I go on in the house. A case of Guinness and a case of deputy in both hands. Because those are beers that Glyn like. So the door open, I walk straight in. Remember what he said? "Christmas come early." And they dropped the beers right in front of Glyn. Glyn was sitting there watching TV. And I look at Glyn. First thing happened, Glenn's face turned red. And he couldn't talk for like a couple seconds. He was speechless. And then I see the smile on Glenn's face. And then it's all right, I gotta go. And it gone. Mommy called me the next day. And Mommy said, "Ro, Glyn was smiling from ear to ear." Yeah. But yeah. So, you know, Glyn was very, very happy. They can tell you another story, you know. No. But me and Glyn met at the Waterfront Cafe in 2004. You know when they used to play jazz, used to have jazz on the evening. You could say it was love at first sight, because from then, they were inseparable. Wherever you saw Glyn, you'll see Mommy. They used to do everything together. They travel together, you know, they go dinner together, go to the supermarket together, they even jog together, you know. And if they go anywhere without the other person, everybody will ask. If Glyn go, Glyn, where's Brenda? And if Mommy go anywhere, Brenda, where's Glyn? And, you know, their relationship was a true love story. True, true love story. Glyn, I'm really going to miss you, man. Really going to miss you. It's so hard to believe that you're not here. So hard to believe you're not here. But one thing I can say about Glyn, Glyn enjoyed his life. He worked hard and he played even harder. So Glyn, rest easy, man. Until I see you again. Just keep the beers cool for me next time I see you. All right.
Thank you very much. Truly endless love. At this time, we're going to have a song on Pan, The Rose by Bette Midler, played by Noel, Samuel, Harry on steel pan. Thank you. I'd like to invite Wendy Collymore for a tribute to Glyn.
Good evening, everyone. This is going to be hard. In 1991, Glyn Williams burst into our family's lives. He was loud, he was lovable, he was a Welsh Liverpoolian Scouser. He took us all by storm with his infectious laugh and his ability to keep up with the Collymore drinking. He was an instant hit. Glyn was totally embraced into our family lives. In fact, he called our mum, Mum. Our late mother told him she loved him like a son. And no matter what, he would always be part of our family. When our mother passed away in 2012, Glyn flew to the UK to help and support his adopted family. I know he felt his loss as deeply as we all did. I was fortunate to have spent time abroad on holiday with Glyn. I recall going to Turkey with my mum to have Glyn and Cheryl turn up out of the blue. We had such a raucous time together. Mum laughed all the time in competition with Glyn's laughter. On holiday to Australia with Glyn and Cheryl, I saw a very competitive side of Glyn. We started playing this somewhat bizarre Australian game called Flags. It involved running along a length of beach collecting flags. Needless to say, Glyn never gave up and won every time. I remember a fabulous trip we all took to Munich with my brother Johnny and his wife Thelma, Glyn and Cheryl. It was for the October Beer Festival. That's a festival, is days and days of drinking beer, which is served in a huge litre tankard. We would be singing German songs, meeting people from every corner of the world inside these tents. And I think we might have done some sightseeing. Okay. My last holiday abroad with Glyn was in 2017. It was for Cheryl's 50th. Her age is given away. The entire family, including my 88-year-old father, went to Majorca. Glyn and Brenda travelled with us, and Glyn spent time with Dad, spoiling him. It was good to see that despite my dad having dementia, he still recognised Glyn, and they would talk about cricket for hours on end. During the hosting, you've heard of this, of the Caribbean Rum and Beer Festival, there were six in total, I witnessed Glyn's outstanding work ethos. Those festivals were not easy to organise or to implement. There was always things that went wrong, exhibitors unhappy with their sites. I saw at first hand how Glyn, easygoing, professional manner, placated everyone. He placated the officials and also the disgruntled vendors. He ensured that everything was done correctly and to a high standard without being overly officious or high-handed, which I think is a rare skill. The family loved helping out at these festivals, and at the end of these two exhausting days of events, we would get together and, yes, we would all have lots to drink. My brothers have shared many memories of their time spent with Glyn. Chris said he remembered every time Glyn came back to the UK to stay with him. Glyn's first priority was a pint of Guinness and some fish and chips. Johnny recalls countless occasions sipping quality rum with Glyn whilst putting the world to rights. Eugene and Ian remember starting nights out drinking with Glyn, but never quite remembered how they ended. Tonight in Birmingham, I am sure that the Collymores will raise a glass in the loving memory of Glyn. I personally remember this amazing, incredible man whose love for life was insatiable. He would fill the room with his laughter, and it was always a joy to be in his company. I know he cared deeply and very protective to all that was close to him. He was a generous man of his time and often went out of his way to help others. Glyn, you will be missed by your family and friends, and I am truly proud to call you my brother. Rest in peace, my beautiful, crazy brother. Thank you.
Thank you, Wendy. This time we're going to have another tribute by Rhonda Ward.
So, I was there sitting down listening to everyone and was so surprised that even, you know, everybody had the same thoughts I did. But, you know, there are probably a few ways one can describe Glyn, but the one that I keep coming back to is his loyalty. He was a loyal friend. You see, I first met Glyn in 2002. At that time, I worked at Baikal. Then he and Cheryl, his CNG partners, we both gathered, came to consult on achieving HACCP compliance. I really couldn't believe my luck. I got to work with a team who actually knew something. They're practical and they implemented the HACCP system in a more simple way. Let me tell you, I always phone Dr. Glyn Williams. He was straightforward. He was down to earth and he had absolutely no airs about him. Probably first time I call you Dr. Glyn Williams. Our relationship soon moved from a work-based relationship to one of mentorship and friendship. You see, he was the one who encouraged me to continue my studies, and he was instrumental and pushing me to complete my master's in engineering at Birmingham University. At that time, he was a professor in the engineering school. Let me tell you, he had a way of making his cohort of students do our work. Dr. Paul Ponder, Ryan Nurse, and I. He made sure to put us through our work. We didn't have any excuses, and we had to be able to turn in something suitable and on time. When I, as his last student, got through that chapter, Glyn promptly relinquished his position and completed his transition to living in his beloved Barbados full time. In fact, I remember the celebratory drinks we had when he got his full citizenship, and he bragged that he was not a true Bajan. This was especially after having had his breadfruit cuckoo and flying fish lunch that very day. Remember, Brenda? A heartfelt thanks to hanging on with me, Glyn. In those intervening years since, we had many a great conversation and I had his counsel on a wide range of topics ranging from my career path to his beloved Everton Football Club, current world affairs, his golfing, the state of the West Indies cricket, and general athletics. He loves sporting and could often be seen going for his jog in the evenings. Indeed, we spent many a time speaking about current world affairs over a drink of beer or two. I can still hear him saying, "Blimey, I'm bollocks to that." But you can't really forget the Christmas dinners and the birthday outings. I love Glyn for his part, most times as the instigator in the rollicking discussions or arguments with the gang of us. Glyn, with his partner Brenda, Louis, Romero, and lately Natasha, Cheryl, and I. I will sorely miss his stories on how he had an afro in the 70s. He had to bring a picture to show me the proof of his course making skills, his Christmas fruitcake, and sometimes just spending an evening with him and Brenda after a hard day's work. But especially his very, very knowledgeable counsel. Until we meet again, my friend, rest in peace.
Thank you, Rhonda. This time we're going to have a poem, "He Is Gone," by David Harkins, read by Keriann Maynard-Browne.
A pleasant good afternoon to all. I would like to take this opportunity to extend my deepest condolences to the family, friends, and all those who grieve in the loss of this great man, Glyn Williams. This poem is aimed at healing your hearts. Glyn is gone. You can shed tears because he is gone, or you can smile because he has lived. You can close your eyes and pray that he will come back, or you can open your eyes and see all that he has left. Your heart can be empty because you can't see him anymore, or it can be full of the love that you have shared with him. You can turn your back on tomorrow and live yesterday, or you can be happy for tomorrow because of yesterday. You can remember him and only that he is gone, or you can cherish his memories and let it live on. You can cry and close your mind, be empty and turn your back, or you can do what he would want. Smile, open your eyes, love, and go on. Rest in peace, Glyn. You will be deeply missed. You lived, you laughed, and you loved. You did well.
Thank you, Keriann. Wonderful poem once more. We're going to have a recessional, "What a Wonderful World," by Louis Armstrong, played by Noel Samuel Harry on pan at this time. Thank you. And may you stand at this time, please.
Thank you.
like to thank everyone who made a special effort this evening to come and join with the family to reflect on the life of Glyn Barry Williams. Thank you very much once more, and have a pleasant evening. After the memorial service, family and friends of Glyn Williams are invited to a light refreshment at Shaker's Grill and Bar, Brown's Gap, Rockley Christ Church. Thank you very much. Have a pleasant evening.
Thank you.